Hello everyone and welcome to another tutorial. So this tutorial is only going to be in After Effects and I'm going to show you how to make this audio react. Okay, let's jump right into it. So first off, you need an image. I just googled HD images and I just took this image right here and just downloaded it. Yeah, so you can take whatever image you want. I downloaded this image, it worked fine. Often with pretty big contrasts works very well for this, but you can try, just experiment with whatever you want. And now you're thinking like, what is this, how do this turn out to be the thing you saw in the beginning, but I'm gonna show you. So jump into After Effects and create a new composition. I'm gonna call this image composition. I'm gonna make it 14 seconds, 30 FPS. That's great. And then I'm gonna import my image. And as you remember, you see this image, it isn't even like high quality, but that's not necessary actually. So let's see here, we have the image and it's pretty basic, nothing cool with that, and I'm just gonna pre-compose it and I'm gonna call this image pre-comp, and this is just now to show you how we can use this image to get some movement. And I use an effect called turbulent displace, just add it into the pre-comp and just drag this amount upwards, and as you see we already have some movement right there. So if we like add it on, let's say 100, and then we put the scale down to 60 and the complexity to, I don't know, 1.3 will be good. And then we go to the beginning, put a keyframe on the evolution, go to the end and we put it on, let's say 15 rounds. So if we press enter now, we have this weird kind of animation. It looks kind of good. It looks like funny, but you feel sick after 5 minutes. And that's not what we want. First off, the image is kind of bad quality and we want some sharper edges. So I'm gonna use an effect called unsharp mask. It's like, I would call it a better version of sharpener, because it takes a little bit more of the contrast edges and sharpens them, instead of like just taking everything in the whole image and just sharpen it. I'm gonna put it on 500. I'm actually using it at maximum. And then we want some glow. So glow. Add some glow. And first off, we want to take this to maximum, because we want it just at the like the bright part, and then put this on like 23. Do you see what's happening in there? Want it like that. First off, I'm gonna make a glow just around this, and then I'm gonna duplicate this glow and make it like a bigger one that doesn't glow as much, but like around it a little bit. Let's put it 4.9, be good. Then duplicate it and have it on 70, so it's a little bit bigger but less glowier, or how to say. So that's actually good. Still have this weird animation. We could actually add some hue saturation also to the layer to increase some colors like that. Do you see? It's a little bit more colors. That's what we want. I'm just gonna save this project. Audio React 4.0. So now I have this, but it doesn't look very, very good. So what I would say is that we need to make some changes, because now it's like it's all, nothing happens up here, all the things happen down here. So I want to jump into the composition where we have the image, and first off I want to make some fast blur. And that's because the image is kind of bad quality, so I want to blur it a little bit. Let's see, 10. And then I want some, actually I could put on some more hue or saturation, I mean. Let's say, I don't know, 25 will be good. Now we have some nice colors there. And then just increase the brightness and contrast a little bit. Like 230. You can actually make it even. We don't have to make the black the blackest, so we make it a little bit more gray by decreasing the contrast. And then this is where the magic happens. We want motion tile. And what motion tile does, if you go down and scale out this, is that it will tile the image. And if you press mirror edges, it will actually mirror the edges, so it doesn't look that bad. And now I will need to, I actually want to scale this out a bit, and we want to make it like that, and scale up. Could actually do it like this, something like that. Oops, like that, and then could actually, oops, do like this. We could enable a proportional grid to see where we are, and then like this, and just put it like that. So like that, that is good. So now we have the image looking like this, and when you go back here, now it starts to look a bit different, actually pretty much better. So this is still the same image, but you know, you can do so much with your creativity. So yeah, this is looking a lot better. I'm just gonna preview it for you. So as you see, it looks pretty good. We're not quite there yet, but we're getting there. So now it's time for adding the music. Music, no. Here we have it. So I'm gonna find the chorus, which should be around here. No, further. Here we have it. It's usually pretty obvious where it is. So there it is. So that's my track, and I want to connect this turbulent displays amount to the bass kick in the song. So as you know, we need to create a new solid called sound keys. I use this plugin a lot. It's really good. I will put the link in the description for buying it or trying at the trial. And in the audio layer tab, we would choose the music you have. And I'm gonna go to range one. I'm gonna go to where I have a kick, and I will go like, let's see now, nope, something like, I don't know, this is so hard, you never know. We'll try it, something like this. Nope. Maybe. Try that. I think that will be good. So once we have done that, we just have to decide how much we want the turbulence to change while we're, when the kick comes in. And I think from 100 to, let's say 700 will be good. So we will go here to the sound keys, range one, exponential, put it on like 1 and go from 100 to 700. Press apply. Now we have the keyframes, and then just go over here and double click the amount. Go to the stopwatch, hold Alt by clicking the stopwatch, take the pick whip and drag it up to the keyframes on the sound keys layer. And as you see now, it moves to the music, so that is great. And the next thing we want to want now, the next thing we want to do is to take all of these layers, Command A, right click, pre-compose. I'm gonna call this the main pre-comp. And so we have a new composition, and I'm just gonna make, I'm actually gonna add now an effect called CC Plastic. You get it when you download After Effects, it's built in, so you don't have to get the plugin for this. And then we can just go ahead and change some things. Put the softness on 15, minus 21. Put this on 125. That's good, that's good. Put the dust on 0. Metal on 50. 85 spectra. And as you see now, we have this cool plastic look. Which I find really, really cool, so that's why I used it. And then we can actually add another unsharp mask. Put it to like 75 to get some more edges. And I think this already looks really, really cool. Next up, we can just add another adjustment layer. You can press Ctrl-Alt-Y or just go new adjustment layer. And we can actually call this color correct. That's what it does. And then I'm gonna actually, you know, you're pretty much finished now. You can render this out and it will look really cool. Or you could actually just use, I'm gonna use a plugin called Magic Bullet Looks to get some cool like effects. I'm gonna use this effect. You see, I get a little bit more nicer colors now. And you should probably also do you know, you have a built-in effect called curves. You can just add it and go over to the blue channel list. Just add some more blue in the scene. That's a lot better. And then you can just go over and I would, for the final touch, just add CC Force Motion Blur, which will add some motion blur to where, as you see here, to the fast part, so it looks a little bit more realistic. But otherwise, I think actually that you're done. Just go ahead and render this out, and we can actually watch how it looks now. So that's how we make a pretty good audio react from a random image on Google. Hope you like this tutorial, and I will upload a lot more now in the summer. So stay tuned, and don't forget to subscribe. Bye.